Hi dear students, welcome to my channel. This video is useful for 8th standard onwards. Keep watching. Okay students, I will explain the problem. Okay, one rope is there. One rope is tied with a ball. You assume that it is a rope and it is tied with a ball. You assume that it is a ball. Okay, you assume this is a rope of length is 1 meter is given and this is a ball, you assume. It is taken aside. I am leaving it. What happens? It will oscillate, no? It is oscillating. So, after leaving, sometime what happens? This angle 30 degrees. When it makes an angle 30 degrees, that time velocity of this ball is 2 meter per second is given. So, you see here I am leaving, it is coming, no? So, when it is coming from here to here like this. So, when it came here, when angle is 30 degrees, the velocity of the ball is given, that is 2 meter per second. Okay? We have to calculate what is the radial acceleration. That is nothing but centripetal acceleration, AC equal to V square by R. This is the V is given, 2 meter per second. What is the radius R? That is nothing but length of the rope. Length of the rope is given, no? So, when it comes from here to here, the velocity is 2 meter per second. The radius is length of the rope. That is 1 meter is given. So, centripetal acceleration is equal to V square by R. Simply V equal to 2 meter per second and R is equal to 1 meter. You substitute, you will get it. Okay? You understood, no? Keep watching forward, you will understand very clearly.
Okay, students, this is class number 34. One problem we will discuss. This is problem number 1. A ball is tied to the end of the string 1 meter in length, swings in a vertical circle under the influence of gravity, as shown in the figure. When string makes an angle theta equal to 30 degrees with the vertical, the ball has speed of 2 meter per second. Question A. Find the magnitude of the radial component of acceleration at this instant. Take g is equal to 10 meter per second square. This is the question. The solution is like this. First, what information given we have to write. The length of the rope is given, no? Length of the string. That is nothing but radius. Okay. So, R equal to 1 meter. And acceleration due to gravity g is given. G is equal to 10 meter per second square. Theta is given, 30 degrees. V is given. The speed of the ball at that instant, 2 meter per second is given. Radial acceleration, AR. Formula we know, that is V square by R. Simply you substitute 2 into 2 divided by 1 equal to 4 meter per second square. This is the radial acceleration. You got it, no? It's very easy.
Okay, students. In this problem, we are going to find out what is tangential acceleration when it makes an angle 30 degrees. I told, no, just before. I'm taking this one side. I'm leaving, no? Why it is oscillating? First, you understand. When I'm leaving this, it's supposed to fall down. For freely falling, what happened? It should fall down like this. But because of rope is there, it is oscillating. Okay? The gravity is downward exactly. But this rope making this particle or this ball to rotate like this. So, this is nothing but a circular path. This is a circular path. So, what we have to do? At this point, the gravity is exactly downward. So, take the component of gravity. That is acceleration due to gravity. Turns into the circular path. This is circular path, no? So, exactly, I will tell you. Suppose this is circular path perpendicular to this rope. Means along this direction. You find out the component of the acceleration due to gravity perpendicular to this radius.
This is question B. What is the magnitude of the tangential acceleration when theta equal to 30 degrees? See the figure here. First, I will explain. This is a vertical line. This is a string. The string is tied with a ball at the end. Now it is swinging like this. Supposed to swing like this, no? You taken from middle to some distance up to here maybe. You left it. It is swinging like this. Okay? At some instant, the angle is 30 degrees. At this instant, it has some velocity that is given 2 meter per second. At this instant, I want to draw one tangent. This is the tangent direction. This is perpendicular to this length. This is tangential acceleration direction. Okay? Towards the center, means along the rope or along the string, towards the center of this circular path. This is AC, centripetal acceleration or radial acceleration. Okay? One is tangential acceleration, one is centripetal acceleration. This is total acceleration. Resultant of AC and AT. It is along this direction. This A is total acceleration. You see here, this is 30 degrees. This is also 30 degrees because this line and this line are parallel. So this is a string. So this angle is 30 degrees. Now I am constructing one triangle. This is hypotenuse. This is adjacent side to the 30 degrees. This is opposite side to the 30 degrees. So this is some kind of right angle triangle. Okay. This is 90 degrees. This is hypotenuse. This is opposite side. This is adjacent side. This is nothing but tangential acceleration direction. This is AT, no? Tangential acceleration. So parallel to this, this line is there. So this is also tangential acceleration. We can find out this tangential acceleration by taking the components of this G downward. This is downward, no? Downward acceleration due to gravity, G is there, no? So it has two components. One is this, that is AT. One is this. What we want is this. This is AT. AT is tangential acceleration. AT equal to G sin theta. Theta is nothing but 30 degrees. Okay? AT equal to G sin theta. G sin 30. Theta is 30 degrees. So AT equal to G is 10 meter per second square. That is given. Into sin 30 is 1 by 2. So AT equal to 5 meter per second square. This is the tangential acceleration. Okay? For more information, I am doing total acceleration also. Total acceleration A equal to square root of AC square plus AT square. Because angle between AC and AT is 90 degrees, no? It is just like Pythagoras theorem only. So you substitute under root of AC is 4, no? So 4 square plus AT is 5 square. AT is 5, no? So AT square means 5 square. So under root of 4 square plus 5 square. So total acceleration A is equal to root 41 meter per second square. This is the answer for this question. I hope you understood.
Okay students, the most important thing what you have to do is just watching this video is not enough. You write down the notes whatever I have given and practice at least 2 times. Then only you will get the perfection. The perfection is most important. Okay. Thanks for watching this video. Please like this video and share this video. And subscribe my channel and tap the bell icon to get the notification for further uploads of my videos. Okay. Till next video. Bye bye Tata. Enjoy every moment of your life.